So we all know that New World has a lot of potential. I wanted to talk about 10 things that need to be added into the game to help it reach that potential. Some of these things are going to be big, some of them are going to be small, but they're all going to be pretty important and pretty impactful. This is in no specific order, but the first thing that I want to talk about is that I would like them to bring in pets into New World. When I played WoW, one of my favorite things was being the hunter class and then going out and picking specific animals and making them my pet and then leveling them up to get like the different abilities and stuff. I just thought that was a really fun part of the game. Now, I realize that since there isn't a class system in New World that everybody could have a pet, but I think they can get creative with that and kind of keep it out of PvP combat, or maybe even have some limitations that allow you to have a pet in PvP combat, but maybe you have to take some debuffs or something like that. But I think it'd be kind of cool if you can get different pets and maybe they can tweak arenas, because arenas seem to be kind of boring and underwhelming part of the gameplay right now, and maybe they can have arenas that you can go into like one-on-one into the arena, but then you can have a pet or multiple pets that go in with you and help you take down the boss, and maybe different pets can have different abilities and you can level them up separately and kind of have like almost a Pokemon mini game within the game. I don't know, there's so many different options where you can have like pet on pet combat and like a bunch of other stuff that they could do that I think would be really awesome to have pets in New World. So I really hope that we do see pets at some point in the future of the game. Another thing that I would like to see is other people's items. Is that weird? I feel like that's not that weird, but I just want to be able to look at somebody, hit the key that you hit to be able to duel people or trade with them, and be able to just hit an inspect key and have their paper doll pop up and you can look up at all their items and see exactly what they're wearing, exactly which weapons they're using, the different skins that they may have on their items. I don't know, I just really like being able to run around, see someone that like looks really cool, and be able to walk up to them, see what that armor set is, so maybe I can go and get it for myself one day. So this next one can be pretty divisive. I've heard both a lot of pros and cons for this. Personally, I would like to see it added into the game, but I want to see some mounts in the game. Similar to pets, I like collecting mounts. It's just another way to feel like you're progressing in the game, is by getting different mounts, and then obviously being able to get to different places faster is really cool. New World has a lot of running in it, and especially when you're questing, it has a lot of running and it can be really annoying. A big downside to having mounts would be that it would be easier to avoid open world PvP combat, but honestly I feel like a lot of people avoid it anyway and just go for the 10% luck bonus and people kind of leave each other alone. I don't know, I think open world PvP is in a weird situation right now as it is, and I don't think that mounts would make it that much worse. I think they could add in something simple to make it like you can't mount while you're PvP flagged or within like a certain radius of other players that are PvP flagged, so they could figure it out is what I'm saying. It's pretty simple. Something I would like to see with mounts is being able to like load them up, like get bags that you can put on your mounts and then store stuff in the bags, obviously, and be able to send them off to transfer things from location to location. Maybe it would put your mount on cooldown and you can't be mounted for like an hour, or like maybe depending on the distance between the two locations, it would be like a longer timer. But transferring between storages can be stupid expensive, and I think this would be a cool way around it, and it would make it so like, hey, since you're sending stuff, you can't be mounted. It's like a good give and take, and I think it would just be a pretty awesome thing to be able to be added in of the game. Speaking of storage of items, can we please just look at our inventory while auto running, please? I know your like paper doll thing makes you turn around when you hit tab, but I just want to be able to auto run towards a location and like salvage items or rearrange stuff in my inventory. There's obviously some other things that you'd have to implement into there to make it so you can't like switch weapons like crazy while you're like PvPing and stuff. But I mean, they already have it, so you can't switch weapons while your abilities are on cooldown. So I don't know, just add it. It would make it so much better. So this one is already sort of in the game with Sword and Shield, but I want to be able to dual wield, and I know they've announced daggers, but they haven't officially announced that you're going to be able to dual wield the daggers. Hopefully they will, because dual wielding is just one of the best things in like any MMO. Personally, I love playing like a high mobility assassin style gameplay, and dual wielding would just play specifically into that. I don't know if we get it, if it's going to be daggers only, or if maybe you can like dual wield other one-handed weapons. I think dual wielding like rapiers or something like that would be weird, so I think they would probably just do daggers, but I don't know. I think I might make a whole other video talking about the aspects of dual wielding, so if you're interested in seeing that, be sure to hit the subscribe button. Speaking of subs, our characters tend to sink like submarines. Do submarines sink? Do they count as floating? I don't know. This is a stupid joke, but I'm sticking it in the video anyways. Give us swimming. Please. That's it. That's the thing I want added. On top of all this other stuff that I'm asking for, can we also get arenas? That would be amazing. 1v1 arenas that could just be like TDM only. But what I really want to see is like a 3v3 or a 4v4 arena where there's an objective and you can have some teamwork and work around the objective. And it just seems so simple. The combat in New World is so good, especially in like small scale combat. I think the 20 versus 20 and the 40 versus 40 is fun, but I think it just ends up being like a stun fest. And obviously, like at this point, the game just stutters and freaks out when there's too many things happen. So if we could have just some small scale PvP, I think that would be just amazing in New World. But I'm going to emphasize again, please give us an arena with an objective. TDM is fun, just trying to kill other players is fun, and maybe we could have that as well. It's a pretty simple thing to just go in, and once one person dies you can end it. But with objectives, it just adds so much depth into the arenas, and I think the game needs that depth. See, I said depth, and this would probably be a better transition into the swimming joke before, but we don't need to talk about it. What we do need to talk about is within the PvP of the arenas, or any PvP in general, can they change the colors of the enemy's healing circles, like the sacred grounds and stuff like that, that our AoE heals? Can they not be the same color as our teammates, so that way if there's two circles on the ground, I like know which one to run towards? Because it's really annoying to just not know which, if I'm gonna like go over here, am I gonna be healed? Or am I not going to be healed? If I'm moving into a heal, I should know whether it's going to help me or whether I'm fighting in an area that's helping the enemy. It's a pretty massive thing and a pretty simple fix. Just make it orange or something. Change the color. That's it. So we basically all know that in the future, the map is going to be expanded. They're probably going to raise the level cap and all that good stuff that happens in basically every single MMO. But what I would like to see is once the level cap is raised and the map is bigger, that we would have specific areas that you have to be PvP flagged in. I know a lot of MMO players are PvE players, but I think you guys could all tell by this point in the video that I lean towards playing PvP style gameplay. I think what can make these areas cool and unique is maybe even make it so it's like a crazy zone where you're not even teamed up with your company and everybody's fighting for their own life. What we're seeing now is a lot of zerging with open world PvPing, where it's like 20 people just running around slaughtering one person, and that's not fun. And I think having maybe like an open world, like free-for-all styled PvP area could be interesting. I don't know. What do you think about that? I think it's a weird concept, but I just came up with it right now, so it's not 100% nailed down. I just think it might be fun. What would also be fun is that if you get killed by somebody or multiple people, that you can have a full death recap. Right now, when you die, you can see the person who landed the last hit on you, and you can see the weapon you're using, but like 95% of the time, the person that last hits you isn't the person that did most of the damage to you. So that's really not that helpful, and also only seeing their weapon is also really not that helpful. It would be cool to be able to see like each individual player, the percentage of damage that they did to you, and then be able to like click on them and see their full builds. This goes back to being able to inspect other players. But I think actually knowing exactly how you died and what was doing the most damage to you and what you're struggling with the most would be a pretty important information to know, right? So if you could see that one player hit you for 20% damage with your bow, but then the other person hit you for 80% damage with a fire staff, you know that you got wrecked by the guy with the fire staff. You actually know what happened, and it would be really nice to know that. If you guys want to know everything that's been confirmed coming to New World, check out this video right here. I appreciate you guys watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe and all that good stuff. My name is Marcus, and I hope you guys have a good day. Later.